King Rudolph sent for me and gave me a secret mission. He thought the Moonlight Witch was distorting people's thoughts, so he ordered me to capture her. There were nasty rumors about her, many of which were biased views founded on the fear of witches. I personally thought there was no need to capture her. The king had never given me such an order before. King Rudolph was a wise man. Even if she was a witch, it was out of his character to order me to capture her without investigating the facts. Though I was skeptical, I set out on a journey to trace the path of the Moonlight Witch and capture her. I heard that she showed up at the shrine in Dean and then took a boat from Raguna to Menarth. I crossed the ocean by following the same route. I finally caught up with her in a small village in Chenome, which I had never heard of. Gueld had beautiful silver hair tinted with a slight shade of purple. When I met her, I knew right away why she was called the Moonlight Witch. Far from the image associated with the witch, she was a young woman, serene like the clear water springing up from a fountain. Gueld turned sad eyes towards me when she saw me following her. She wasn't feeling sad because of her fate, or for me, though. She was worried about the disaster that was about to befall all the people in the world she loved. Gueld shifted her eyes to a little stream and said, "Before long, the people of this country will be depressed by the growing gap between the rich and the poor. The clear water of this little stream will also become clouded. But this is nobody's fault. Nature is merely reflecting what people desire. Capture the Moonlight Witch. If she resists, kill her." From the beginning, I wasn't sure about those orders. When I met Gueld, I thought I rediscovered the truth I had almost forgotten. I decided to accompany Gueld on her pilgrimage. She traveled from one town to another, leaving various prophecies at each place she stopped at. She was sounding alarm bells about the ominous future. Her words taught what people must do and things to watch out for. Of course, not all heard the words of the Moonlight Witch favorably. This was before Camden Chapel were created and before people had any power to use spells. Many were afraid of Gueld because she had a power they didn't. Some were openly hostile towards her. Still, Gueld continued her journey. The guy bumping. Although she was a powerful witch, Gueld was only 18. She must have been hurt many times by people's reactions. Nobody knew how important her pilgrimage was. Nobody knew who she was doing it for. The young woman kept on traveling to save the people who didn't understand her, knowing that she would be insulted. No matter how hard she preached, she was not understood. She couldn't talk back to those who called her names. Watching it with my own eyes, it was painfully clear to me how much she was hurting. She told me about the mistake my country Fulthia was going to make, and the disastrous wave that was approaching. She even told me she had to die before she could fulfill her mission. She knew her own destiny. Still, she had to complete her pilgrimage in order to leave some hope for the future. There was no way I could arrest her. I decided to return to Fulthia and ask the king to rescind his order to capture the Moonlight Witch. I wanted to talk to her one more time before I left. However, that fated event that she talked about many times happened to her without warning along a road covered with thick snow. Who's that? Oh! Ravas? I just froze. So that was him there. I wonder if it was because of the power of Ravas. Or, now that I think of it, it could have been Gueld who was doing that to me. If I could have moved my body, I would have attacked Ravas with my sword. Gueld might have used her spell to freeze me so I couldn't attack him. She was prepared to die in order to leave the path of hope. Gueld was killed by Ravas, but she might have decided to let Ravas kill her. Let him kill her, says Yurio. Gueld's role was to pursue the Queen of Another World and stop her evil plot. The Queen of Another World, says Huck. It looks like my sense of foreboding was right. Queen Isabel, the woman who drifted onto Darufus's shores, was a witch from another world. But unlike Gueld, who also came from there, her purpose in coming here was to destroy the world. But why? Asks Yurio. Chris says, why does she have to destroy our world? I don't know. Gueld somehow learned about Isabel's plan and came here to prevent it. Of course, the task was so enormous she couldn't accomplish it by herself in the time she had. Gueld had to leave the mission to a future generation. She had to hope people noticed the signs and began to understand the seriousness of the matter. Chris says, wasn't Gueld afraid of being killed? Even though she was a witch, she was still a girl about your age. She must have been terrified about what was going to happen, even if she knew it was her destiny. Life is the best gift you can ever receive. Gueld threw that away and sacrificed herself for us. So sad. After Ravas left, I secretly buried Gueld here. King Rudolph was stripped of his free will by the Queen's spell and became nothing but a puppet for her to use. I continued to secretly watch Ravas and the Queen. However, 3 years ago they caught me at it and locked me up in the Tower of Darufez. Stella says, is there any way we could stop the wave of Rayuol? Yes, there is one way. Gueld taught me about it. It requires the Silver Dagger. The Silver Dagger, says Yurio. Yes. There's a globe that Ravas used for his ceremonies, located in the observatory that the Queen had built. That globe is what is drawing the wave of Rayuol towards us. The globe is protected by a shield generated by Isabel's power. However, the Silver Dagger inherited the powers of the five shrines and can break the protective shield. But there is one condition. The dagger must be used by someone who has actually been to all five shrines. Okay, well there's two people who fulfill that, those conditions. Otherwise, the powers of the shrines will not be available. Yurio says, so if the globe is destroyed, we can stop the wave of Rayuol from coming. I think so. Badat says, we don't have much time left. Why don't we go to the castle at once and destroy the globe? Hold on, says Yurio. We understand more about the wave of Rayuol now. But why is Foltheus trying to start a war? If their purpose is to destroy the world, wouldn't calling the wave of Rayuol be enough? Huck says, you're right. I was thinking that too. Additionally, we can't explain the purpose of the emotionless soldiers in the prophecy. Durzel says, I overheard Isabel and Ravas talking in the castle. They say that the wave of Rayuol is drawn by feelings of grief. If a war breaks out, people will wail and grieve for the dead. I think the war is the bait to call the wave of Rayuol. That's horrible, says Chris. Starting a war to trigger the destruction of the world. Durzel says, now let's begin. Gueld is dead, but her power is still present in these hills. Draw that power out with your silver dagger. Chris, Place your staff in front of her grave. Since you can use the chapel spells, your staff will be able to help you. We can transfer Gueld's power into your staff so she can protect you. My staff, says Chris. You mean this one? The one Grandpa Lap gave me? Well, that's why we couldn't sell that thing all this time. Yes, that's the one. Uriel, Durzel says. Yes? Place the silver dagger just like you did at the shrines. Okay. Chris says, wow, I feel tremendous magical power. Yurio says, look, the sword has started to glow. Oh. Chris says, the staff, Grandpa's lap staff has changed shape. Durzel says, it has become Gueld's staff. You carry the staff. It will surely help you. Chris picked up Gueld's staff. Yurio says, this sword looks brand new. It was so rusty just a minute ago. Is this also Gueld's power? I didn't expect that to happen either, but that must be the reason. You carry the sword. It's a gift from Gueld. But this sword belongs to you, Master Durzel. The time when a sword was the symbol of a swordsman may be over, but I made a decision. She may have been destined to die, but having failed to protect her, I have no right to carry a sword. Somehow I feel you are the right person to carry that sword. Well, okay then. I will use it. Yurio takes Durzel's sword, Esperancer. Huh. I gotta check out these weapons. Please forgive me for dragging you into this. Right now, though, you are our only hope because you visited all 5 shrines. Don't worry, says Yurio. We were thinking of going to the castle anyway. That's right, says Chris. The Moonlight Witch sacrificed her life for this. We can't turn a blind eye. I'll come too, says Stella. Badat says, me too. Okay, I guess Badat's rejoining the party. Take me also, says Joanna. Okay, well, that's over the amount of members we can have. Wait a minute, says Huck. A spirit of teamwork is important, but I have some doubts. I'm not sure if destroying the globe alone will bring back peace. If something so simple could block the wave of Rayuol, surely the Moonlight Witch would have done it. She must have thought of many ways to prevent the globe from being made in the first place. Chris says, Uncle Huck, we're all ready and raring to fight, you know. Don't rain on our parade. Durzel says, don't be so upset. Huck has a point. There may be some other facts we don't know about. There's something I want to check, says Huck. Badat, Joanna, could you come with me? Where, says Badat. I want to go back to Godona. Yurio says, but thousands of soldiers are guarding the border. If there's a will, there's a way. I want to check out the ruins of Godona. They're the oldest ruins in Tirasweel. We may be able to find out more about the wave of Rayuol. I see, says Durzel. Well, we've been there. We didn't find anything. That's a good idea. Please go and find out what you can. Okay, then. Badat, Joanna, and I will go to Godona. The rest of you should head for Castle Rudo. We'll return there as soon as we know something, I promise. Please wait for my report. You must buy as much time as possible. Yurio says, but what if the wave of Rayuol comes too close and we can't wait any longer? We must destroy the globe then, right? It depends on the situation. I'll leave the decision to you. Chris says, but what if our decision is wrong? Let's see. Oh, yeah. Then we will apologize to Gueld together in heaven. Chris says, I don't want to apologize. Me either. We're running out of time. Badat, Joanna, we must leave. Yurio says, hey, uncle. Yes? I still have your notebook with me. Oh, that notebook. You keep it. It may help you. Don't worry. I memorized everything that's written in it. Anyway, we're heading out now. I'm excited. Huh. Chris says we're finally going to Castle Rudo. Stella says, do you think Huck, Bada, and Joanna can get to Godona safely? No worries, says Yurio. Uncle Huck has a very good luck. That rhymes. We should go too, says Durzel. Right, says Yurio. Let's go, says Chris. Things will work out. The Moonlight Witch left us a trail. Yurio and his friends rescue Durzel, an old swordsman who had been imprisoned in the Tower of Derufez. Durzel leads the party to a hill, where they find the Moonlight Witch's grave. Gueld had passed away long ago, yet the travelers have little time for mourning. Durzel tells them about the ominous situation within Castle Rudo. The astrologer Revas and the otherworlder, Queen Isabel, were carrying out a massive plot to bring about the wave of Ra-Yual. Parting ways with Huck, Badat, and Joanne, who head to Godona to find out more on the wave of Ra-Yual. Yurio, Chris, Durzel, and Stella head towards Castle Rudo with renewed resolve. Chapter 7, Journey's End. That was a short chapter. Epilogue. Gueld. Durzel says, let's head to Castle Rudo. Okay, says Chris. Right. Let's go, says Yurio. Stella says, stop talking and get moving. Wow. That's so sad, she's dead. Died so young. You know, she was 18. She'd be 38 today. Figured she'd still be around. Anyway, what do we have? Yo-Yo has Sylphing. But we got a new sword. Esperancer. Look at that. Brings his speed down by 20, though. But we must use it. His attack is 300. With Esperancer, it becomes 350. And his magic attack is 125. Goes up 20. Wow. And then Chris will use Gueld's staff. Her attack goes from 149 to 153, and her magic attack from 196 to 211. That's awesome. Let's save. That was some long cutscene there. Look at these things. So, Road of Remembrance. We're supposed to head north. Fight these things. Minerva and Kraken? Don't they? Release the Kraken! Magic burst on this one. Missed. Didn't miss. Oh my god, 124? didn't do much. He goes hoomph when he attacks. $650 damage, nice. These things are tough. Wow. Chris with 21 points. Need some healing. I'm really glad for her healing powers. Bring it on. I doubt he can one-shot these things, but it's bound to damage them in any case. Well, these things can move far and still attack. Oh, he one-shotted that. Nice. Yeah, I can see how his speed went down. 999 points on those. Wow. I suppose. Oh, I mean to choose that one. Oh, we need healing. At least Stella does. Luckily, the thing moved closer to him. Okay, so the one that was damaged is Kraken B. We'll go after that next. Actually, I'll have Stella hit that one. Nice going, Stella. Yeah, we'll hit the Kraken. Ow, 5 points on Chris. I would have gone after Chris if I were you. Instead, she killed you. Here we go. Ah, just short. Got fleeting food. Oh, I wonder if that thing's hungry. That thing, sorry. I didn't mean to refer to you as that thing. Our beloved pet. You are hungry. How about some stony type food? Wow, we were really damaged there. The monsters are a lot tougher now. I don't need to fight all of you. Oh, what'd you find? I don't need that. I'll fight you. We gotta choose our battles, you know what I'm saying? There's rocks in your face. Or a big rock. Couple finishing moves and some regular attacks. Missed. This probably won't even kill this, yeah. Go Chris! Okay, now go Chris. Okay. Now go Chris. I didn't kill anything. 560, nice. I think this is the one that Stella hit, and it was also damaged by the rocks, so let's finish that off. We'll hit the Kraken A with Durzel. They're falling like flies over here. Uriel, instant level. 36, he's learned sixth sense. What is that? Gotta be a skill. Got diet food. Temporary immunity to physical attacks. Sweet. That might come in handy. Still on the road of remembrance. Supposedly we can head west. That's not west, that's east. To Rudera. Chris says, this road is so deserted. Stella says, there aren't many travelers because this road is mainly used by soldiers coming from Castle Rudo. Dozel has nothing to say. Ambushed at the signpost. Oh, she's low on magic. Well, we have Yurio's finishing move. Wait, no. Wave Rush. Yeah. Missing? Unfortunately, that other Kraken is left out of the fun there. Looking forward to checking out Durzel's finishing move in the next battle. Chris levels up to 36 and has learned Aura. We're all level 36 now, sweet. Balance in all things. Let's see what Chris learned. A skill. Recovers lost magic points. Huh. She can use that now. But she has missing magic points. But you know what? For now... we'll use a mind potion. And another. We still have the Remind Potion and the Full Mind Potion, so I don't think we're even going to need her skill. East is Rudera Gate, 1422 Milos. South is Arosa, where we came from, 410 Milos. And north is Castle Rudo, 116 Milos. Now, what if we head east? Durzel says, we don't have time to waste. We must hurry to Castle Rudo. Alright, let's fight this thing. Durzel, Comet Thrust. I'll focus it here. Well, it's gonna hit three of them then. Oh, two of them, I guess. Strike true, trusty spear. Comet Thrust. Sweet. So it does just hit one. 982 damage, wow. I'm not sure what's damaged. Just hit this thing. Wow. Healing. Nothing more than healing. Mm-hmm. Close enough. Rudo, the capital of Fothia. And other stuff. Let's just get rid of this thing. Still a finishing move. Magic burst. You know, these things are gonna move around. By us now. Yo-Yo! 13! Alright, that only hits a single thing anyway. Oh, I think I can actually catch other monsters, but they have to be really close by. Let's see if Chris can heal him. If anything attacks him, that's it. Unless it misses. He missed! We got lucky. I think the Kraken have less hit points. I'll just get rid of them. Stella, getting close. Ah, just shy. Sweet. Anyway. So Rudo is right here. We will go there next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.